One of the top pound-for-pound fighters in the world, Canelo Alvarez, has refiled his lawsuit against DAZN and Golden Boy. Now, Canelo, Golden Boy, and DAZN are currently under mediation. They're going to try to work out a deal. It was reported a couple of weeks ago that they offered Canelo a $20 million per fight deal with the opportunity to make more money based on how many subscribers he brings in. I think what really started this is the lack of communication between Canelo, DAZN, and Golden Boy. I mean, in numerous interviews, they would ask Canelo, is he going to fight Triple G? Canelo said he's not interested in fighting him anymore because he proved what he needed to prove. On the other hand, you heard Oscar saying, well, this fight will happen in May. Oh, the Triple G trilogy will happen. You know, I don't think Canelo had any idea that he would have to fight Triple G again, and that's one of the stipulations of the contract. I just thought Canelo should get the fight out the way and fight Triple G. I thought it would be the easiest fight out of the trilogy for him. I thought it would stop Triple G because you could see he was slowing down. He's not the same. You saw him against Derevchenko. Even the domestic undefeated fighter from Canada, Steve Rose, was getting off on Triple G. And once I saw that fight, I know Triple G wasn't in his prime anymore. And I think Canelo would destroy him in a trilogy. But DAZN considers that a premium fight. They think the Triple G fight will bring him a lot of subscribers in. I can't speak for anybody else. This fight does not interest me. What does interest me is I want DAZN to give a list of fighters, of premium fighters they want Canelo to fight. I don't want any UFC fighters in there, no Logan Paul. We're talking about professional fighters that would bring in subscribers. I would like to see Canelo against Andre, but I don't think that's going to bring a lot of subscribers in. Or I would like to see Canelo against Jermall Charlo. But that's just me being a boxing fan. I don't think Jermall Charlo will fight on DAZN. David Benavidez be another good one. But the question is, other than Triple G, will any of these fights catch the casual fan's eye? Are those considered premium fights? I would like to see Canelo be undisputed in a division. Rather, it's 160, 168, 175. More than likely, 168 and two guys who fight for DAZN, Billy Joe Saunders and Colleen Smith, two undefeated in their prime super middleweight champions. But from DAZN standards, those are not premium fights. Very interesting. In other boxing news, the Fury vs. Wilder trilogy has been moved once again. According to Tyson Fury's co-promoter, Bob Arum. This time, it's not moved because of the pandemic. It's moved because of a big college football schedule on December 19th. That is because the college football season started late, so the championship games will be starting later. Bob Arum was advised to change the date of the fight so he could attract more of a crowd. Bob Arum said this does not mean that the fight will happen in 2021. He said this fight could happen early December. The only date early in December I can think of is December 5th because Pulev and Josh was fighting December 12th. I'm not buying it. I believe it when I see it. I think this fight happens in 2021, which makes a very interesting decision for Eddie Hearn and Anthony Joshua because Anthony Joshua fights Pulev December 12th. If he gets past Pulev, he will not have to vacate the WBO belt if he doesn't want to. He can take on the mandatory Alexander Usyk if the Tyson Fury Wilder trilogy takes place in spring. Some boxing observers said Anthony Joshua was contemplating and dropping the belt because he wants that Tyson Fury fight bad. Now, since his Fury situation came up, and let's be honest, they don't want to fight December 19th anyway because they want a live crowd. Bob Arum, Frank Warren, Tyson Fury, Deontay Wilder want all the money they can get. Wilder is close to hanging him up. Tyson Fury is only interested in big fights and not legacy. He's not interested in defending his title. He said it himself. He's not interested in fighting anything but big fights, meaning big money. And Wilder is an easy payday for Tyson Fury because he's not that good. The AJ fight, on the other hand, will bring Fury stacks of cash, and that's why he's taking it. And these are things Fury says himself if you listen to him. He's not interested in fighting the top 10 contenders in the heavyweight division because he believes they're beneath him or he's just scared. Leave your thoughts or comments below about the Tyson Fury trilogy situation or the Canelo, DAZN, Golden Boy situation. Jay Beezy. Subscribe to the channel. I'm gone.